So this is such a vast improvement over the way we've been counting people walking and people biking. The city of Portland has some of the best data about bicycling in the United States. The main way we count bicyclists in the city of Portland is we train hundreds of volunteers to stand at an intersection for a couple of hours in the morning or in the evening peak and stand there with a clipboard and a notepad and count every person on a bike that they see, one by one. You can imagine the opportunity for error in that process. You can imagine that a couple of days of data at one intersection, what does that really represent about a corridor? What does that really represent about those conditions in winter versus summer? There is a lot of room for improvement in that data collection, needless to say. You know, it wasn't that long ago, maybe a decade ago, transportation planners thought it was innovative to stick GPS devices on bicyclists and monitor their movements. What we learned from that about 10 years ago was that people on bicycles will go out of their way to find a safe, comfortable bike route. That helped us understand how big a population we could serve if we make safety improvements on one corridor. We can bring people on bikes from half a mile away or more. They'll avoid a hill. They'll avoid a really busy, congested street where they feel unsafe to get to that safe corridor. These days, we have smartphone apps where people on bikes are recording their trips automatically and rating them. Ride Report, based here in Portland, is an innovator in that space. We're working with Ride Report to follow the location decisions and travel patterns of bicyclists all over Portland, and we're excited about the possibilities there. This cloud-based technology here with GE and Intel and PGE and AT&T is going to help us understand in a really comprehensive way everyone that's moving on three high crash corridors in Portland. We've never been able to look at every transportation mode together. People driving, people biking, people walking. Parked cars is another issue. In any busy commercial district, you have a shortage of on-street car parking spaces. And as Portland is growing, more of our neighborhood main streets are finding it's harder and harder to find a parking space. So if we can find out when the parking shortages are happening, we can better address that with parking permits or time limits or other incentives to help people free up those parking spaces to ensure better access for businesses, customers, employees that need to get to those businesses.